Bioinformatics micro modules. What are phylogenetic trees? In this module, we introduce some concepts about phylogenetic trees, as well as several basic assumptions and important terms. A phylogenetic tree is a tree that describes the evolutionary relationship between different biological entities, such as species or strains. For example, the tree of life tells us how all species on Earth were evolved from a common ancestral origin. Each branch point records a speciation event in which a species became two. Different species that have only been evolved from a common ancestor recently are close to each other in the tree. Based on this idea, all species on Earth can be generally classified into three domains, namely bacteria in blue, archaea in green, and eukaryota in red. Domain is only the first level of this taxonomy. If we go deeper, under each domain we have kingdoms. Under each kingdom we have phyla, and then classes, orders, and so on. Let's use the animal kingdom as an example. Cats, ocelots, and tigers belong to the same family. Dogs and wolves belong to another, while different kinds of bears belong to yet another family. Let's look at some more examples. Among the plants, some are called vascular plants that can transport water quickly. Among the vascular plants, some are flowering plants, including the roses. If we keep going deeper down the tree, finally, we can reach a particular kind of roses called moss rose. Similarly, among all animals, we have chordates, which are animals with a notochord. Among these animals, we have birds. Again, if we keep going down the tree, we will end up with a particular kind of birds. After seeing these examples, we may wonder how phylogenetic trees are constructed. Of course, phylogenetic trees should be defined based on the evolutionary history of organisms. However, given that we cannot go back to the past to observe how species or strains actually evolved, we need to use some observable features to infer the phylogenetic tree instead. For example, species that are evolutionarily close to each other usually share some morphological properties. For instance, we can classify animals by asking whether they have jaws or not. Then, among those animals with jaws, we can classify them by having lungs or not, and so on. Other than morphological properties, we may also use other observable features. For example, bacteria can be classified based on some of their chemical properties. There are also other observable properties that can be used. The question is, which feature should be used first? How do we know that animals were separated by having jaws or not earlier than having lungs or not? In bioinformatics, one way to deal with this problem is, instead of using these features, we use the similarity between DNA, RNA, or protein sequences to objectively and systematically infer phylogenetic trees. Our goal is to reconstruct phylogenetic trees that are as close to the actual evolutionary history as possible. We use the term reconstruction because we are not defining evolutionary relationships between species or strains, but rather just infer these relationships that have already been defined in history. In order for this reconstruction to be possible, we need to make several basic assumptions. The first assumption is that all sequences that we analyze come from a single ancestral origin, which we have been implicitly assumed along this discussion. The second assumption is that all the current sequences are the results of mutating the ancestral sequence. The third assumption is that mutations are rare events, such that if the similarity between sequences A and B is the highest among the three pairwise comparisons between A, B, and C, meaning that these two sequences can be produced by a smaller number of mutations from an ancestral sequence as compared to these mutation numbers of ANC or BNC. Then sequences A and B should be placed closer to each other than to sequence C in the phylogenetic tree. By doing so, we assume that A and B were separated later than their separation from C. Before we end this module, let us define some terms related to phylogenetic trees that we will use in the coming modules. Recall that in computer science, a tree is defined as a graph with no cycles. In the case of phylogenetic trees, each node represents a sequence, and each edge connects an ancestral node to a descendant node. The leaf nodes represent the currently observable sequences. Each internal node represents an unobserved ancestral sequence. The root node is the common ancestor of all the sequences. And the branch length may represent the evolutionary distance, which means the amount of time between the two divergent events connected by this branch. In our current figure, since the phylogenetic tree is drawn from left to right, the branch length involves only the horizontal part of the connecting line between two nodes. Phylogenetic trees can also be drawn from the root, with the root at the top, on the bottom, or on the right with no difference in meaning. So far, we have been assuming that the position of the common ancestor in the phylogenetic tree is known, in which case the tree is a rooted tree. If the position of the common ancestor is not known, we can use an unrooted tree to represent the evolutionary relationships between the sequences. In a later module, we will discuss different methods to deduce the root position of an unrooted phylogenetic tree to turn it into a rooted tree.